You are watching BPD-TV.
Good afternoon. You're watching BPD-TV. I'm Detective Jeremy Silbert alongside my partner, Sergeant Anthony Smith, and this is your daily update for Thursday, January 10th, 2013. Good to see you.
Good to see you.
Today, we are answering your questions live during our broadcast. Not to ask a question, email us now, bpdtv@baltimorepolice.org, or you can submit your questions via Twitter, keyword Baltimore Police. We already have a lot of people who are on Twitter talking to us. Rose Allen, we want to thank her for her well wishes and good thoughts with the police department. Thanks on Twitter. He's telling us that we're doing a great job with our officers out there.
Great.
Going after guns. And Amy, we do put a lot of good news on Twitter, not just bad stuff. So please stay tuned. We a lot of community stuff.
Great. Last night, the Northwest District hosted a community meeting at our public safety training facility. The entire Northwest community was invited, and it was a great turnout and practically was standing room only. Police Commissioner Batts attended this event along with members of our command staff and the Northwest District. Mayor Stephanie Rawlings-Blake and members of the City Council also attended this event.
Commissioner Batts discussed some of the department's goals moving forward in 2013, including going after gang members with guns and continuing community engagement, technology, and intelligence. We had the opportunity to speak with Patricia Rideout Howard after the meeting. Ms. Howard is the president of the Northwest District's Community Relations Council.
The purpose for this is for us to talk amongst each other, to know what the problems are that we are having, to be able to converse to the police department in an intelligent manner of what is happening, but also to educate ourselves. For if you have a house that's a nuisance abatement that's next to you, we teach you and or call in CPHA or the community law center to show you how to write the appropriate papers and what to do in order to get rid of either the people that's in the house or the house itself once it has been down. We work with going into the schools and talking to the kids, meeting the kids on the phone, just finding out what they're doing. We work with the city council, we work with all of the community relations presidents, but basically we work with the citizens in the Northwest District all over to come together and have you.
And what's the best way for someone to join the Northwest CRC?
The best way to join the Northwest CRC is come to this meeting, January the 22nd at 7 o'clock at 5171 Ricestown Road, the Northwest District Police.
From time to time on BPD-TV, we talk about our community relations councils, and it's important to remember that all nine of our police districts have these CRCs. They're really a great way for the community to get tuned into the police department.
Absolutely. They're really dedicated men and women in the neighborhoods.
Absolutely. Every month these organizations meet. If you are interested in joining, please contact your local police district and ask to speak to someone in the neighborhood services unit, and they'll tell you when the meeting is held every month. Moving on, our robbery detectives are asking for your help to identify a robbery suspect. On January 8, 2013, at approximately 1:40 p.m., an unknown suspect robbed an 88-year-old woman on the Walgreens parking lot located in the 6300 block of York Road.
After the robbery, the suspect fled the location. Investigators are attempting to identify the suspect who was captured on video surveillance. The suspect is described as a black male in his 40s, approximately 6 foot in height and 240 pounds. He was last seen wearing eyeglasses, a black knitted cap, black leather jacket, and a white t-shirt. Anyone with information as to the identity of the suspect is asked to contact the Northern District Detective Unit. They can be reached at 410-396-2455, and callers can remain anonymous.
Recent weeks, we have been called to investigate several robberies in Southwest Baltimore. This is the area of Edmondson Avenue and Mount Holly Street. In many of these incidents, the victims told investigators they were attempting to sell iPhones and other Apple products to individuals who they met on Craigslist. All of the victims were unfamiliar with the area where these robberies took place.
While detectives are continuing to investigate these cases, we want to remind everyone out there some safety tips when arranging to meet someone with online purchases. Meet in a public place, preferably where there are surveillance cameras or a large number of witnesses around. And always, don't bring cash with you. Don't allow the seller into your vehicle also.
Absolutely. Some other things we really want to stress, it's not a good idea to go alone. Tell a friend, tell a family member where you are going, and you should consider having someone go with you. It's also a very good idea to pay with a certified or bank check made payable to the seller before you get to the location, and let the person know that you're going to come with a certified check.
Right.
This prevents you from bringing large amounts of cash.
And if they're hesitant, if you say, I'm going to pay with a certified or a bank check, and they say, no, I want cash, that's a red flag right there. You might not want to deal with that person.
Absolutely. But like you said, meeting in public places, somewhere where you know there are surveillance
or
cameras around.
Police districts, Come to a police district. Tell them to meet you there.
Absolutely. And now it's time to answer some of your questions. Reverend Wiley, we want to thank you for following us on Twitter, and please continue to interact with us there. The first question that we got today comes from Russ. This is about an ongoing investigation. What are you doing about the senseless killing of pets? This absolutely has to be stopped. It is becoming widespread throughout the nation, and I assume that this question is in reference to an incident that happened in Baltimore last week involving one of our officers who encountered a dog.
Well, thank you for your question, Russ. The Baltimore Police Department has a rich history of partnering with numerous breeds of dogs in our canine section. This partnership between the men and women of BPD and our canine friends has helped to get countless guns and drugs off the streets of Baltimore. Now, we are dedicated to this partnership as we look to expand our canine section by numerous more dogs in the coming months. And there are actually dogs in every police district right now. One of the hardest things Baltimore police officers have to do is engage dogs who pose a threat to the safety of our citizens and officers. We're an agency that's trained and accustomed to working side by side with our canine partners. However, it can be extremely difficult when encountering unknown dogs. A split-second decision can leave the public and officers at great risk. For years, officers have come to the aid of needy animals. Many officers in BPD have discovered stray dogs and have taken them home to become members of their families. But so often these incidents go unnoticed. However, recently, a BPD officer gained national attention by adopting a stray dog. Officer Dan Waskevich and his dog Bo can be seen on the mayor's campaign, Show Your Softer Side, to prevent animal abuse and neglect. I think we have a photo of that. Our agency and Commissioner Batts are committed to providing the community with the highest trained and professional police officers. Now, of course, we will evaluate this incident and determine if any additional training or better training that is needed.
Absolutely, and I believe one of the billboards with Officer Dan and the dog, anyone that's coming downtown, it actually happens to be right next to police headquarters
right
at
outside.
The intersection of President and Baltimore Street.
Right.
There's, as soon as you're driving on President Street, you'll see the billboard with his. We have time for one more question. Gina's telling us.
Yes, we have a question from Philip. He says, hello, I'm looking to join Baltimore PD. I would like to get information on special units in Baltimore PD.
So it sounds like he's asking within the police department what type of specialized units we have. And all nine of our districts have operations units, but we have a wide variety of other units. We have our aviation unit, we have our marine unit, we have our canine unit, we have the mounted unit. And a lot of these units we've profiled over the past year on BPD-TV, and we'll continue to do that.
Mm-hmm.
So good question. We thank everyone for the questions
today.
Thank you for interacting with us on Twitter. We'll continue to do this from time to time. Sergeant Smith and myself and everyone else from the Public Affairs Office will take your questions and answer them. But again, we want to remind everyone to follow us on Twitter, keyword Baltimore Police, for real-time news and updates. You can also watch BPD-TV live Monday through Friday at 12:30 p.m. or watch past episodes 24 hours a day by visiting our website at baltimorepolice.org.
You can also watch a rebroadcast of this program every night at 9 p.m. on Baltimore City's cable channel TV25. Thanks for watching BPD-TV. Have a great day.